Madam, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Madam, I just wanted to bring it to the notice of the August House as well as the Minister. Sir, from 2014, you have brought about 7 ordinances. In spite of Parliament running regularly, of course, this COVID, there was a gap. Otherwise, the Parliament was regularly running. And what was the necessity to bring so much of ordinances? And I have no other option to call you, this is an ordinances Raj. And this is an ordinance government. Sir, you have brought government ordinances in 2014, the coal mines ordinance, the coal mine second ordinance, the right to fair compensation transparency in land acquisition ordinance, the ordinance again second time, and the right to fair compensation and transparency in land acquisition ordinance in 2015, negotiable instrument ordinance 2015, and again 2015 same ordinance, and enemy property ordinance 2016, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I think 5 times that ordinance was brought. Then the Indian Medical Council ordinance 2018, 2019, and again 2019, 3 times. The Muslim Woman Protection of Rights and Marriage ordinance 2018, 2019, and 2019 again. And this bill, Homeopathy Central Council ordinance bill 2019, and this Homeopathy Central Council Ordinance 2020 again. Sir, what is the necessity, whether the government is interested to run on the ordinances or to make a law when there is the Parliament is regularly running since so many years, except this COVID environment? Madam, I wanted to speak on Indian Medical Central Council bill first. Madam, it is a stopgap arrangement. The bill is a stopgap arrangement to temporarily supersede the Central Council of Indian Medicine owing to its poor functioning. See, it will be replaced by the proposed National Council of Indian System of Medicine. Madam, the supersession of the Central Council, this bill provides the supersession of the Central Council for a period of 1 year until when the Board of Directors will be constituted to exercise its powers. Madam, the Board of Governors can consist up to 10 members. That is the prescription in the bill. And I wanted to ask you, you have mentioned you will appoint eminent persons in the field of Indian medicine or eminent administrators. The board bound by the directions of the central government on policy matters. Sir, I wanted to ask the government through you, madam, see why the 10 members has not been prescribed. How many members from the Indian medicine expertise and how many will be the administrative background? See, the day may come you may not appoint the Indian Council, Indian medicine expertise at all. There will be only the administrative or ex officio members. What will happen then? The whole board will be running by the officers or by the government directions. Sir, you should prescribe. In other bills, there will be 3 experts. When you brought a bill on research and teaching of Ayurveda in Gujarat, you have mentioned in that bill 3 experts will be there and 3 secretary and Ayush minister will be there. And in this bill, why this specification is not there? If you don't appoint the experts, the professors, the field experts who have done research in that, who have taught in medicine for so many years, if you don't appoint them, what will happen to this board, sir? And you have also already mentioned
silence.
It will be the central government on policy matter. Central government will going to give directions. If that is the case, I wanted to ask, what about the autonomy of this board? Sir, there will be no autonomy even in the field of academics. If you don't maintain the autonomy in the field of academics, what will happen? These boards, the Indian Medicine Council board, will be run under the government directly and under the minister directly. Sir, it is fine that you are a doctor, you are here in this ministry, health and family welfare. If there is a minister who is not a doctor, who doesn't have knowledge about the health and family welfare, then the whole committee and the whole board will be run under a person who is not having any knowledge about the medicine. What will happen then? So at least for that sake, I request you to precisely mention,
you
out of 10 members,
winding up, Anantayaji. You have 2 minutes.
5 should be experts, and rest you can appoint ex officio members. And there is one more important factor, madam. The yoga and naturopathy is totally kept away from this. Who is interested in this, and what is the vested interest playing in this? I wanted to know. Sir, the Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji always, every year after he comes to this government, following yoga as a national day, celebrations will be done. See, in the name of yoga, you wanted
please
to
observe
claim
order here, please.
The supremacy.
Excuse me, please.
In the name of
order.
Yoga. Sir, at the same time, you don't want to prescribe a syllabus.
On the right hand side, please
you
observe order.
You don't want
order.
To have
so
naturopathy
happening.
As the study material. You don't want to have it as degree, but you wanted to take the advantage of it. Sir, I wanted to ask you, how can it be done when yoga and naturopathy are kept away
Honourable
from
member,
this?
Honorable member, you will have to wind up, please.
So, 1 minute, madam. Madam, academic autonomy must be maintained in all the government bodies. Whenever there is a UGC, please maintain the autonomy.
Please wind up,
here
sir.
Here also, you please maintain the. So, I request Board of Governors will exercise their powers based on the direction given by the government should not be there. They should work.
Okay, I'll be calling out the next
then
member, Anmanteji,
the
please wind
up. Taken up regular item of the council of the ministry. So, madam, I request through you, please make these amendments and we will pass the bill. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.